Okay, hello and welcome back to another episode of Cisco's Adventure RPG. So, if you guys were here last episode, we defeated Cisco, and now we are going to defeat the Fel King. We just finished getting some dark steel, which cost us a bunch of netherite, so for all that work, please subscribe. It was kind of dope. But now, we're going to use the Podium of Purgatory, the Tainted Talisman, to defeat the Fel King. And if he kills us, I'm going to lose a lot of stuff. So, let's hope he doesn't kill me. That's a Meecher. That's what we were looking for like an hour earlier. Anyways. So, apparently we killed the Fel King in one hit. Cool. I got one Tablet of Ascension from that. Dope. And a couple champion coins. Cool. That was underwhelming as hell. But you know, it's kind of funny. So we got our Tablets of Ascension. You know, for this, I'll just pick a perfect jewel of the Archmage, because that's the rarest gem that we can get. Get some Tablets of Ascension out here. Nothing even too crazy. Like, I just... It could have been so much wilder. You know what? We'll kill him again just because why not? Tainted Talisman. What's this? 14. We've got how much left? 8. Is that enough for anything interesting? 3 for that. We'll kill all the sins, I guess. We'll kill the 7 deadly sins along with the final boss. So I have 1 coin left. Oh. Sons of Sins. That one's off kilter, but anyway. I have 1 coin left. 5 champ versus 3 for 1 block. What? What kind of trades are these? Anyway, Sin of Wrath. We need that too. Anyways, let's kill another Fel King. Cool. What did we get for that? Pretty much the same as we got for the first one, except for less. So that's not even that crazy. Anyway, let's kill you. We'll kill you. We'll kill you again. Kill you. Kill you. Kill Kelvin. Kill you too. Kill you too. And now we have the 7 deadly sins killed. So that's all of these guys. So let's just claim everything. Bunch of levels, some champion coins, some amethysts, some wisdom scrolls, an amethyst golem charm. You know how it goes when you just kill all the 7 deadly sins. We got 60 champion coins for that. Ascendant difficulty. Cool. Global of all dimensions. Okay, so just reset 7 deadly sins chapter. Wait, enemies at rare levels will drop more loot? You know what? Let's increase the world level. Wait, I can increase them all. I just do all of them. And then I need absolute equilibrium, and I can raise it by 150 again. And then reset the deuce chapter. Anyway, lesser evils, we got a mutant creeper, we just need 3 of those, and then we get a small pathetic boss gate portal. Gate pearl, sorry. It's nothing crazy, so I don't know. Gate of Memoirs, pearl, we get a Cisco, and we get a bunch of champion coins for it, which is kind of crazy. Fel King, we get a Tablet of Ascension, so how do we make that? Divine Ruby and a Tainted Talisman, okay. Um, So gateways to eternity, I can do that. We get some divine rubies from that after spending a bunch for it. So, okay, cool. Cataclysmic gate pearl. We get some ignium from it. Necklace of the desert. Champion coins. Radiant sun shards. Some more ignium. Okay, what about... how do we make this? Oh, we can't. Okay, well, that's cool. Yeah, there's, like, we pretty much just did everything that is, like, the difficult things for this mod pack. Because we're so insanely overleveled. But we're gonna ignore that, and we're gonna try and finish the entirety of the mod pack. So, seven deadly sins, we can kill them again. Everything is a higher level, so it's quite cool. Cisco's fate, we just need to... the full Fel King set, you just need Dark Steel on the on Netherite. Fallen Hero set is Netherite on Cisco's stuff, which is Bright Steel with a Radiant Ruby. So we might as well do the Bright Steel, Radiant Ruby stuff now. Just give me a second to go get ourselves some gas tiers. Okay, just got ourselves our end crystals now. Now we can go back to the end, which I didn't mark because I'm smart. Give me one second to find it again. Okay, well, now that we found the actual end portal again that works, let's mark it. So, edit. And then... negative 19, negative 1, what is it, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1671, perfect, now it's right here, now we go back to the end, and now we kill the endy boy again, the ender dragon. Nothing too crazy, nothing too simple either. So what we do is we do the 1, we do the 2, we do the 3, we do the 4. Resummons them. We gotta wait for the crystals to all respawn before we can start shooting them, though. Because they're protected. And now we just gotta wait. And then we're gonna shoot them all. Now we wait for him to fully spawn. Oh wait, I forget what we're supposed to do here. We're supposed to grab... I have to grab that stuff. Oh shoot, I accidentally stopped recording. We're grabbing all of this stuff that we can. So, got Stum Dragon's Breath. Huh? Oh, there's a shield on it. How much damage does one of our sword swings do? Oh, it just kills it. Okay. That's why we brought multiple crystals, because we needed multiple crystals. It was worth bringing them. Shoot. It took one of our crystals and exploded it instead of... that's a pain. Oh well. We got what we came for already. I'm not upset. I could use a little bit more though, because we do need some for each to get the divine rubies, so. And then we'll need to kill some more withers as well. Will you please shoot me with your breath, bro? Brisky? Brisky? Come on. Come on, shoot me. Shoot me, brother. Perfect. Then we get all the juice. We collected it all. Perfect. Shoot that one. Shoot that one. Oh. Shoot. Well, he died from that, so that's cool, I guess. Didn't intend on killing him, but apparently our arrow just did that much damage. Cool. I mean, it's neat, but, like, it's annoying when I'm just trying to figure out and get stuff that we need. But, you know, it's whatever, I guess. Okay, we have the dragon's breath. We can put this stuff back in here. We have a singular dragon egg. Yep, just the one. We can kill some withers out here, too, while we're at it, actually. I just need to make sure that they spawn correctly, so 1, 2. We'll spawn one over there. One over there. Perfect. So the moment this guy spawns in, he dies. The moment this guy spawns in, he's gonna die too. I'm just ready to absolutely obliterate him whenever he spawns in, which is just the greatest. Come on. Come on, spawn, bro. Spawn. I know you want to. Anyway, how many do we have now? Wait, where did I keep them? They're in here. There's 16 now. 16. How many do we need total? I got a storm's edge, that's cool. Let's do this. Keep doing that. Gotta stop doing that. Insta-deadificated. I think it might be more efficient to actually kill them by hand. Because we're only getting one per if we do it this way, but I think if we kill it by hand, we'll get more. Oh, I'll do a test here. So we've got one per by killing it with the bow. If that changes drastically by killing it with this, then... Then it's... Yeah, I mean... Yeah, so we're not killing him with the bow anymore. We're killing him by hand. Cool. We're killing him with our bear sword. Level 200 wither. Insta-dying. And giving us... One per each now. I guess there's a chance to drop more. I mean, we've already gotten what, however many we need. So I'm just going to get these last two. And call it there. Just because no reason really to go overboard. Other than because it's funny. I mean, like... We're one-shotting the final bot. Wait, 70? What the? I guess we just got the really lucky loot explosion. I don't know. That's insane. 75. Cool. So now we've got those guys. We've got all of these wind cores. Divine rubies. We're gonna do two at a time for these upgrades, so two of each, or actually we can do three of each core. There's only four different types of cores, so Divine Ruby. Now we get three of you. Now we need 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, perfect. More Divine Rubies. Now we're at 6 Divine Rubies, 7 total. Now, just get a couple more. I mean, we do need all of them. I believe in total we needed, I don't know if we need 10, but I know we at least need 7. So, I mean, it can't hurt, right? I mean, it can, but like, it doesn't hurt. So, it's all good. So we've got all of these Radiant Rubies. We need 4 of them for our armor for right now. So in the smithing table, we get the Cisco's chest plate, and then using 1 netherite, we get the Fallen Heroes stuff. From there, we need all of the more Divine Rubies and Arcane Bright Steel blocks and stuff. We'll get all that stuff in between episodes. But for now, we're focused on getting these Radiant Rubies onto here. And then we need to netherite it. So let's get ourselves 4 netherite as well. Take off all of our armor. Go back to being a semi-mere mortal. Upgrade him to the Cisco stuff. Then RK upgrade him to the Fallen Heroes stuff. And now we've got that. I mean, this stuff is already kind of crazy. But jeez, I don't even know. I don't know what to say. Nightfall is another thing that we need to do with the sword. I'm contemplating, do we just make another Sunbring Equilibrium and upgrade it from there? So I think that's the play. Cause what do we need for this? Just gold, netherite scrap, so we need, in total, 1 netherite, 2 netherite scrap, what is it, 18 gold, 1 block of iron, 1 block of iron, 1 more scrap, 2 diamonds, and a stick to get another Slumbering Equilibrium. So this, then to this, then we get this, then we get Slumbering Equilibrium. Then that's just the sword that we have right now. Then to awaken it, we need a Radiant Ruby. So good thing we have that. So now we have Awakened Equilibrium. Very slow sword. Which we then upgrade to Nightfall using a Dark Core. Which we can buy for some champion coins. So Dark Core, Cisco's Wear. Dark Core. What else do we need for it? A netherite. So we've got that right here. So now we get ourselves Nightfall, which is one of the pieces for Absolute Equilibrium. The other one is another Awakened Equilibrium. So now we just need 1 more of you. And another stick. Another couple diamonds. Another netherite. Another 3 of you. Another 9 gold. Or 19, 18 gold. Another singular block of iron. We do that whole thing over again. Then we get that guy. Do the upgrade. Then for this, we just need Tablets of Ascension, some Arcane Bright Steel, which we get 3 light cores. We just need 4 total for that full thing, right? We already have the Tablets of Ascension, unless I'm incorrect. Okay, so for another Tablet of Ascension, we can get that from killing the Fel King, or... Yeah, so we get that from killing the Fel King, which we can get from getting the Tainted Talisman. Which you can make the Taint, but you can't make the Tainted Talisman. So we got 3 more Tainted Talismans. We need 1 more of them to get absolute equilibrium. But we also need the Bright Steel blocks, which, again, we already have the stuff for that, so... Get 4 bright steel blocks. Do that. Arcane bright steel block. Now we'll go over, we'll kill the Fel King, which apparently might give us even better loot now that we've gotten that. Yep, gave us 2 that time. 2 Tablets of Ascension that time. We kill him too fast for him to spawn minions. That is how fast we are killing him. We also got 3 dark steel, which is kind of cool. But now we can get ourselves the equilibrium. Yup, absolute equilibrium. Best sword in the game. And now we can do with that sword. Is Godforge it. Sophisticated absolute equilibrium. I mean, overall it's kinda nice. I don't know. It doesn't have enough slots though. This one's the only one with the slots, so I don't know. I could get some refreshers, I guess. Just make more netherite swords for the refreshers. No, I can use some Cisco stuff. Yeah, we'll use that for the Ciscos for the refresh. Now we're getting a 5. 51 attack damage, 4.75 attack range, 2.71 attack speed, basal. You know what? What are the bonuses? Protection pierce versus life per hit, fire damage, extra crit chance. You know what? It's absolutely legit. It's just sick like that. We're just gonna do that. The other thing that we need to do, honestly, we can just break that down, because why not? We just get extra Godforged Pearl. Now that we have the best sword in the game, we also have the Fallen Hero stuff already on. We just need some more Tablets of Ascension. Is this for every piece? So, Tablets of Ascension, you need them for the helmet, the boots... The chest plate. Okay, so you need 2 for each one. 2 for each one and Divine Ruby and Radiant Ruby each. So... Wait, that's it. What else did we need for them again? Oh, Arcane Bright Steel. We can get that easy. So... Just the coins. We have a couple more. We get a couple for killing each one. Is there any, there's a capturing enchantment. Wait. Is there a spawn egg for him? Oh, yes! Okay, we're just gonna get absolute crazy enchants on that sword in between episodes. But for now, we just need some more Tablets of Ascension, because we need 8 total Tablets of Ascension, so... I have enough for 2 more. Tainted Talisman number 1, Tainted Talisman number 2. Then Divine Ruby. For even 1 more. Perfect. And then I can just dupe the rest if I need to. Okay. So now... I should probably use my good sword. Oh shoot. We took damage from that one. That hurted. That was kind of nuts. We took damage. We needed our ring. Wow. Okay. So he starts hitting harder at higher levels. That's cool. We also got the Ember Blade. Cool. We didn't really get any other cool weapons, though, so we'll leave those in there. But for the Arcane Bright Steel, we're gonna need to make some of those things, right? The light cores, which are glowstone dust, they're easy to make too. Oh my gosh! Okay, well, next episode we'll be doing some crazy armor upgrades, so stay tuned for that. Anyways, GG's, peace. Wait, how many do I need per? I need 2 Radiant Rubies per. So I'm gonna need to make a couple more Radiant Rubies. So, okay, how much do they cost? They cost all these guys, which aren't even that okay, we're just gonna get all that stuff. I'll see you guys next episode for that. That's gonna be real fun. Anyways, GG's, peace. Have a great day. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.